Gildan Media presents Your Coach in a Box, affordable, life-changing audio programs.
Ask and you will succeed. 1001 Extraordinary Questions to Create Life-Changing Results, revised and updated, read by the author, Kenneth D. Foster. Ask and you will succeed is a breath of fresh air in the marketplace crowded with advice on what to believe and how to live, filled with powerful questions that invite you to listen to your inner voice and tap into the strength you need to create your ideal life. This book makes you the final authority in your own life, not outside forces that you can't control. Packed with thought-provoking questions related to the creative laws of success, Ask and You Will Succeed shatters the myth that your success depends on advice, hard work, or ambition of others. Instead, Kenneth Foster presents life-changing questions that, when answered by you, will help you define and attain success in every area of your life. By utilizing the questions in this book, you'll uncover the true nature of your own mind. If you ask the right questions and do the work, you'll find that prosperous thinking flows into every aspect of your life effortlessly, relieving you of the stressful negative thoughts that block your creativity and halt your drive for success. Through the process of asking and answering these wise questions, you'll learn to live in harmony with yourself, succeed in business, improve your physical health, build strong relationships, and engender fulfillment, energy, and enthusiasm for life. No matter what you do in life, you'll find a renewed sense of purpose, extraordinary wealth, and unending love for what you choose to do in life. All you have to do is ask. Ask and You Will Succeed is the result of Foster's lifetime of work, helping people transfer their attention from failure to success, worry to calm, distraction to concentration, restlessness to peace, and negativity to positivity. When you ask yourself these questions, you'll grow from mastering tasks to mastering yourself and begin a journey to unlimited wealth and unending success. Kenneth D. Foster is a successful entrepreneur and business coach. He is the founder of Premier Coaching and CEO of Shared Vision Network, a professional development network for soulful entrepreneurs. He is considered one of the top success coaches in the nation and has helped thousands unearth their truest desires, define their ultimate vision, discover their true purpose, achieve at higher levels, and create lives filled with abundance and happiness. To find out more about Kenneth's programs, go to www.premiercoaching.com. Ask and You Will Succeed, 1001 Extraordinary Questions to Create Life-Changing Results, revised and updated by Kenneth D. Foster. To my beloved friend and spiritual teacher, Paramahansa Yogananda, and all who seek wisdom and the power to realize their true nature, unleash their full potential, and bring forth unending success in this world and in the afterworld. Acknowledgements. I would first like to humbly acknowledge my Creator and the loving presence that comes through my writings and writes all the scripts in life, the spiritual source of creation within all of us. The gifts that have been bestowed on me by this divine presence are too numerous to list. So I have found that by living in the presence daily and carving my own beautiful life sculpture, I have become the gift that I once sought. I would like to thank my teachers and guides, seen and unseen, that have guided me through the maze of life and protected me from harm's way in all my affairs. I would like to acknowledge my sincere love for the thousands of people who have passed through my life, whether my closest friends, family, casual acquaintances, enemies, or someone just passing by. Each of you has shown up in my life at exactly the perfect time and place to teach me what I sought or needed to learn. Each and every one of you has brought me untold gifts of wisdom, healing, compassion, laughter, joy, and love, and for that I am eternally grateful. I would like to thank my mother Edith and my father Donald Foster, sister Kathleen Munns, and brothers Kevin and Kirk Foster, who have given me the gift of unconditional love and the space to ask new questions. I would like to acknowledge my daughters, Brooke, Erica, and Tara, and all my family members whose presence in my life has given me unending inspiration and the courage to pursue greater dreams. And most importantly, I wish to express my deep gratitude and appreciation to my best friend and loving wife, Judy, for her unending compassion, patience, guidance, and love. I would also like to express my profound gratitude to my agent, Bill Gladstone, and the team at John Wiley & Sons, and all those who have directly or indirectly contributed to this project. Foreword. Ken Foster has done it. This book has the power to change your business and your life. There is no book on the market like this one. Through his studies of human behavior and the mind, Ken has come across the simple yet profound formula to tap into higher realms of consciousness using the power of questions. This book will feed you emotionally, mentally, physically, and spiritually by showing you the way to use your mind in obtaining what is most important to you. Through Ken's simple method, he will show you how to focus your mind like never before. And as a result, you will tap into the hidden strength within you and find the answers to your greatest challenges, avoid new disasters, and bridge the gap from where you currently are to manifesting your greatest dreams. Ken is a master thinker. When it comes to teaching people to go within and ask the right questions, no one else can touch him. He is the Socrates of our time. The pace of life is too frantic for most people. Like being in a bad movie that won't stop. They are working more hours than ever, worried about their futures, concerned about the planet, juggling finances, and trying to keep up with the massive amounts of information bombarding them on a daily basis. Many people carry the tremendous burden of guilt because they feel unsuccessful and are unhappy, discontent with their life. This is not the way to live. Can you relate to this? There is a growing need for people to balance their life and take back control. Ask and you will succeed will help you do this in many ways. And the benefits apply whether you are a CEO, corporate employee, entrepreneur, or homemaker. The more sweetener you put in the water, the sweeter it becomes. Likewise, the better questions you ask, the sweeter your life will become. As I read with fascination the questions in each category, I found myself instantly asking and applying the questions to ongoing projects and relationships of my own. Therein is the great value of this book. You can instantly ask a new question and change your focus and direction immediately. The questions in each category are asked in such a way to affect your thinking at once. I've asked on many occasions over the years, what can I do to help more people live an incredible life? This has probably been the most asked question of me throughout my career. The Success Principles, the Chicken Soup for the Soul series, the Power of Focus, the Aladdin Factor, Dare to Win, Maximum Confidence, and Peak Performance, which have sold millions of copies, have all been focused on answering that question. So when Ken asked me to write the foreword to his book, I looked to see if this book would help more people live an incredible life. The answer was an overwhelming yes, because it helps people form the habit of introspection. Introspection is the key to living an extraordinary life. If you can look at yourself or your business dispassionately and recognize that you have faults and weaknesses, then you can change. People who don't analyze circumstances never change and rarely succeed in the areas of life that matter most. Ken has provided the categories and the right questions to help you take stock of what's happening in your world. When you go to bed each night, review your day and go over your experiences. How did I react today? Did I empower others? Did I meet my goals? Where did I let myself or others down? What areas can I improve upon? Did I use self-control when the situations were irritating? Ask introspective questions and your life will get better. This book helps fight the battle of scarcity thinking. Ken Foster knows far too well the ravages of wrong thinking and asking the wrong questions. He lost all his possessions twice in his life, but he pulled himself out of it. His results speak for themselves. He knows we are here to live life fully, to live it abundantly, to find joy in what we are doing, and to use our mind to expand and magnify our lives. He has given you the key to unlock the life you have always wanted. The key is one that you already hold, but you may not be using it effectively. It is the key to success that the prophets, spiritual leaders, and inspirational speakers have tried to tell us for thousands of years. Success is not about looking outside yourself for something that you don't have, but rather reaching inside to find what is already there. Your level of personal fulfillment, prosperity, success, and financial wealth can be traced back to the questions you ask and the actions you take on a daily basis. Ken Foster has dedicated his life to coaching others and helping them tap into their inner compass to success, and he will teach you that anything is possible if you dare to ask. The success I have enjoyed can be traced back to the questions I asked. I have dreamed big and asked big questions over the years, which have resulted in unending success. You can too, by asking the questions found in Ask and You Will Succeed. Jack Canfield, co-author, Chicken Soup for the Soul. When many people think about success, their thoughts almost inevitably turn towards career, business, and finances. In today's society, we place a high value on career and business success since we spend so much of our lives in the workplace. However, as important as your business success is, it's not the whole story of your life. In fact, there are those who would say that true success is really about our deepest values and not just about the externals. And furthermore, your business, career, and financial successes are hugely influenced by the success you have in other aspects of your life. Your health, your relationships, your spirituality, your life purpose, and many other life experiences that don't have anything directly to do with money, but which nevertheless determine whether we are truly rich or not. We see many driven businesses and time-squeezed, high-pressure entrepreneurs out there. They may have achieved enormous financial and professional success, but when we look closer, we see that their lives are gravely out of balance. Almost inevitably, when such a driven person reaches midlife or beyond, questions arise in that person's psyche, such as, is that all there is to my life? How come I have so much, but I still don't feel happy? And everyone says I'm successful, and my bank account says that too. But why don't I feel successful? You may be an individual who's been attempting to establish yourself in business, and it's just not going the way you want to. You might say to yourself, I'm trying really hard. Nothing's really working out. I didn't get the promotion. The bank turned me down for the financing. I'm never in the right place at the right time. Chances are that the obstacles you're encountering only appear to be external. The real obstacles preventing you from achieving your goals are inside you. And until you find them and root them out, success will continue to elude you. True success is success in all parts of your life. You certainly want to achieve the highest business and professional success you're capable of. But you also want to be happy, feel in tune with your life purpose, have fulfilling relationships, and a spirituality that connects with the larger web of life all around you. I wrote this book to help you explore all the realms of your life. The method I have used, a system of searching and provocative questions on all the topics in the book, is a tradition thousands of years old. The great Greek philosopher Socrates, who lived from 469 BC to 399 BC, was renowned for teaching his students by asking them questions. Whenever a student brought up a subject for exploration, Socrates would not answer the student's questions. Instead, he asked the student a question about the question, and upon receiving an answer, asked the student another question about that answer. According to legend, this process could go on for hours. Imagine some of the initial frustrations Socrates' students might have experienced when the master would not answer their questions directly, but instead force them to explore their own issues by tackling the questions themselves. Socrates knew, and his students soon learned, that the answers to life's most pressing questions do not dwell in some outside authority, but instead within each human being. The method of teaching by questions has come to be known, not surprisingly, as the Socratic method. I give the Socratic method my own particular twist in this book, which evolved over the last 14 years of working with hundreds of individual coaching clients and through my own self-exploration. In its classic form, the Socratic method involves the use of questions to create a dialogue between a teacher and a student. Here, in these pages, you will be having a dialogue, but not with an external teacher. You'll be dialoguing with yourself, but not with just the surface level of yourself. These questions are designed to take you deeper. You will be exploring realms of consciousness that are rarely explored by most people. You'll be peering into your subconscious and superconscious mind to bring forth your inner truth, wisdom, and intuition. You'll be asking yourself the questions in each section, and then answering yourself, then asking more questions, then answering more questions. You'll be teaching yourself about life, your life. By asking yourself these extraordinary questions, you will be your own Socrates. The questions are specifically designed to help you discover the values, beliefs, and rules by which you are currently living, and to help you create quantum breakthroughs in the areas of business, finance, career, health, relationship, family, spirituality, and more. Believe it, at this very moment, you are capable of amazing improvement in all areas of your life. Your innate power is waiting to be realized, and by following the step-by-step formula for asking, answering specific questions, you will tap into that power. You will find wealth in all areas of life. You'll discover what you need to achieve success in business. You will greatly enrich your relationships. You will deeply connect with your spirit. You will significantly enhance your personal effectiveness and achieve harmonious balance, happiness, and fulfillment. Yes, you will do this and much more by understanding how your mind works, and then by simply asking the right questions, connecting with your inner truth, and following through with daily actions. We live in an abundant universe where there is no shortage of anything. Look around. In truth, there's no shortage of food, water, money, clothing, housing, love, or happiness. It's everywhere. But as Socrates knew thousands of years ago, there is a shortage of right thinking. Why do some nations have so much and others have so little? It comes down to how we use our minds and how we distribute our resources. We've often gotten off track. There are many reasons for this. The primary reason, however, is that there is a shortage of wisdom, compassion, creativity, focus, and discipline. Albert Einstein was quite ordinary in many ways. He did have one extraordinary quality, however, the ability to engage in disciplined contemplation. He had a unique way of focusing his mind. He asked himself searching, deep, and even sometimes whimsical questions to open up his creativity. By asking himself, what would it look like to ride a light beam? He conjured up what is now known as the special theory of relativity and his most famous equation, E equals mc squared, which he claimed came to him in a dream, no doubt percolating in his psyche from the questions he was asking. The powerful questions he asked changed the history of physics and how we look at our universe, and you can do the same. Why do so many people just settle instead of creating a life filled with an abundance of love, happiness, and wealth? Because most unsuccessful people live life from the outside in rather than the inside out. They are driven by their baggage instead of being inspired by their soul. They listen to the opinions, advice, and counsel of others instead of taking time to realize what's real, valuable, and right for them. Eventually, living this way causes their dreams to die, their visions to wither, and they get stuck and mediocrity, just hanging in there, listening to what others think is best for them. On the other hand, there are those who take time for honest introspection and notice the patterns of their life. They have respect for themselves and take care of themselves. They review who they are becoming by their actions or non-actions. They look at what is working or not and make adjustments with a positive attitude. They know that everything counts, and they take full responsibility for their actions and their lives. These individuals are the truth seekers, ever looking at improving their life and making a difference in the world. To change the conditions of your life, you must become aware of the way you're using your mind. From the moment we open our eyes in the morning until we close our eyes at night and drift to sleep, our minds are filled with thoughts passing through our consciousness. Where do these thoughts come from? Well, we are like radio receivers. We tune in and attract certain thoughts, just like tuning into a radio station brings you music or news being played by that station. the top quantum scientist, neuroplasticity scientist, ancient religious texts, and great spiritual leaders of our time all concur that thought comes to us by the use of our brain and by the focus power of the mind. The new thought of today is, train your mind, change your physical world. Deepak Chopra has written many books over the years on the mind-body connection. We are seeing today more evidence that not only can we use our minds to heal depression, chronic fatigue syndrome, weight issues, high blood pressure, and even cancers, we are seeing studies that our physical universe can actually change using the power of the mind. We have the ability to tune in to the subconscious mind, other people's minds, and the superconscious mind, or as some have put it, the mind of God, and harvest the power that comes from this infinite source. Since you alone rule your mind, it is up to you which thoughts you focus on and what the world you live in will look like. Whenever you ask yourself a question, you are fine-tuning your mind to seek the answer. This is a simplified version of how the mind works, but ask and you will receive the answer. Questions focus the mind. When you change your focus, you will consequently bring in a new awareness. And when you change your awareness, you will change what you know. When you change what you know, you will have a new understanding. And when you change your understanding, many times your feelings will change. And when you change your feelings, you'll most likely change your actions and ultimately change your destiny. This is the power of asking the right questions. It puts you in charge of a compelling destiny. Thinking is a process of asking and answering questions. You are constantly engaged in this activity. Psychologists tell us that the average person has about 60,000 thoughts each day. What most people don't know is that the average person also asks the same questions over and over, resulting in the same 60,000 thoughts the next day. Is it any wonder why things stay the same? How can things change if you think, say, and do the same things over and over? You must focus your mind in a new direction and change the questions that you are asking for real change to take place. Your greatest thinking shows up in all areas of your life. What you believe and the questions you ask is either propelling you to unending success or stopping you dead in your tracks. Simply put, if you want to change your conditions, you must change your thinking process. And you alone are responsible for your thoughts, and consequently, only you can change them. So how can you change your thinking? Here's a proven formula for making quantum improvements in your thinking and life. Set a strong intention for what you want. Be absolutely honest with yourself. Ask empowering questions. Gently quiet your mind. Patiently listen for the deep answers, which may either be simple or profound. And finally, take the right actions. If you don't get the answer immediately, don't be impatient. Dive deeper and keep asking until the answers come. Remember, when you hear the truth, you will know it. If you have any doubts, it may not be the truth for you. Note, if you are a person who has a habit of doubting, you may not know the truth when you hear it. For you, I suggest paying close attention to your choices, going as far as writing down each choice you make, so you will know when you are tuning in to a worldly thought or your own intuition. As you learn to embrace your intuition, the right actions will follow. You can change your thoughts and beliefs almost instantly when you clearly understand your current reality, know what has been stopping your success, have a well-defined vision of where you want to be, possess a strong purpose for getting there, and devise and follow an action plan to achieve your goals. Let's briefly discuss the mind and how to tap into this treasure chest of resources. There are three main areas of the mind: the conscious, subconscious, and superconscious. The conscious mind is composed of your current perceptions and what you think is real. The subconscious mind represents all the thoughts, memories, and emotions that your conscious mind has perceived, interpreted, and recorded over your lifetime and now lie buried below the level of your daily consciousness. You can access your subconscious mind through hypnosis or simple questions designed to awaken this powerful part of your mind. The superconscious mind is where your true genius, wisdom, power, and joy are located. This is your connection to your source. Like an iceberg, most of which is hidden beneath the waves, the answers to your deepest questions live in the part of your mind that is mostly beneath your awareness. Remember that the expanse of an iceberg beneath the surface is just as real as is the tip above. Similarly, the expanse of the superconscious mind that embraces both your conscious and subconscious mind is just as real. This part of the mind is like a treasure chest full of jewels and unlimited wealth just waiting for you to open it. You can access your superconscious mind by quieting your thoughts and asking powerful questions. Pray to God first, for He is your greatest resource. When the superconscious mind contacts the divine, it is assured of success because it is attuned with God's unlimited power. Provide your mind with the gift of deep contemplation and be very still. Notice what comes up and practice listening to yourself. Ask anything you want to know and then wait quietly to observe your thoughts. You need not make any effort. Just sit in silence and observe from the depths of your total stillness. As your intuition swings into action, you will clearly hear the answers to your questions. This lucid voice will open up your creativity and allow you to connect to your inner source of truth. You will recognize what you truly believe and what actions you want to take with ease and grace. The superconscious mind is where your reservoir of life force is located. It is the source of unfathomable wisdom, creativity, and joy. When you learn to draw from the deep well of your mind enthusiastically and deliberately, you will increase and multiply your innate resources until you are saturated with unbounded success and happiness. You will quickly realize what a hopeless task your conscious mind engages in each time you try to manage your affairs without accessing your all-knowing superconscious mind. The superconscious mind has never been influenced by either your conscious or subconscious mind. It has never known a negative belief, word, or action. It is the living part of your divine inheritance. When you tap into the superconscious mind, every part of your world will change quickly and bring you unending success and joy. The secret to progress is through self-analysis, by daily asking high-minded questions. Introspection is a mirror in which you can sort out where you are strong and what is impeding you. Learn to examine yourself dispassionately. Find out who you are, not what you merely fantasize yourself to be. For example, in the evening when you retire, create some time to ask some of the questions in the book that resonate with you. Commit to doing this for a week and see what kind of results show up. For instance, you may ask, what great memories did I create today? And what areas did I make progress toward my goals? What has to happen for me to create more success in my life? What am I putting up with? What do I keep repeating that is disempowering me? What can I do tomorrow that will change my life for the good? By doing this, you will become more aware, feel more in control, and ultimately make the changes that are necessary to have an outstanding life. Focus is the key. Whenever you ask and keep asking, you will find the answer. I repeat, whatever you ask and keep asking, you will find the answer. This is true for disempowering questions as well as empowering questions. Questions like, why does this always happen to me? Why am I such a jerk? And why didn't I get the promotion? Will lead you down a path that you may not want to go. So make sure you're asking the right questions. The average mind is like a water-soaked match. Scratch it, and there's no spark. It will not light. But with the power of asking the right questions with focus, a concentrated mind is like a flare. Strike it, and it immediately is aflame with creative ideas flowing outward and upward, which manifest in the material world. So what has to happen for you to focus your mind and change the way life is showing up for you? First, you must learn the one question breakthrough model. By learning this model, you will tap into the natural way of getting to the right answers for you. These are not someone else's answers. These are the ones that are right for you. By consistently following this model, you will see results beyond belief. So before you answer the questions in this book, commit to the following. Never think or say, I don't know or I can't. Be 100% honest with yourself. Stay with the question until the answer comes. Let go of any doubt that you have the answer. Take immediate actions when the answer arrives. Now find a place where you will be undistracted. Take a few long, deliberate breaths in while you simultaneously tense the body and then release the tension on the out-breath. Next, pick a category in the book where you want to improve. Read through each question in that category and note the ones that you feel compelled to answer. After selecting these questions, read each one, and as you do, reflect upon each word, its meaning, and the meaning of the whole question. Next, close your eyes and allow your honest answers to bubble up to your conscious mind. On the surface, it seems like you may be able to answer most of the questions in the book without much thought. You will be best served, however, by asking the questions many times and then answering the questions after deep contemplation. Sometimes the answers will not come immediately. It may take days, weeks, or months, but I guarantee that if you stay with the question and don't turn off the power of the superconscious mind by making statements such as, I don't know, or I can't, or I don't care, you will always find the answer that is right for you. After contemplation, quickly write down your answers in a journal. It's a good idea to keep a journal of your answers and commitments to review your daily progress. The Ask and You Will Succeed journal is available online at www.asksucceed.com. Finally, set a strong intention to make the changes you desire and take immediate action in the direction of that change. Simple, yes. Easy, probably not. It will take focused attention daily to change past habits of thinking and behaving. You have the power to change. The spirit of inquiry is in all of us. Everyone in this world, sooner or later, will seek success, truth, happiness, and fulfillment. You will seek it either wisely or blindly until you have fully reclaimed yourself. And it is never too late to change, improve, or mend. Remember, daily introspection combined with contemplation of dreams, goals, and desires that burn the hottest in your mind will carry you forward to finding your true power. Just follow your innate compass, and it will point you towards success, freedom, joy, and happiness. Everything is perfectly aligned right now for you to maximize your potential and live the life of your greatest dreams. So never, ever give up on your dreams. Never give up on having the kind of business you want to have, the kind of relationships you want to have, or the overall quality of life that you want to have. Keep asking the right questions and you will succeed. Section 1, Questions for the Big Picture. Values Clarification. Right choice is a function of living our highest values, so too, it is the key to a life well lived. What are values? They are ideas and principles we hold most highly in our lives. They bring us the most meaning. They're the North Star by which our soul navigates. The values you emphasize in your life may be different from another person's values, but it's surprising that when you ask people about their values, similar themes emerge. There seems to be a spectrum of high values such as justice, courage, love, and dignity that resonate with many people. In my own life, the values I hold most highly are spiritual values, values of loyalty, values of abundance, family values, and values of friendship. There are two questions you can ask yourself to help you identify your primary values. I've seen people go through long workshops to arrive at understanding how to express their values, but our values are really already within each one of us. And if we ask ourselves the right questions, our values will readily reveal themselves. Ask yourself these questions more than once to get to the core of your values. Your first answer is the surface answer. Subsequent answers will take you deeper. The first question is, what about success is important to you? A lot of people will respond, I don't know. But if you just go to, I don't know, this immediately shuts down your mind. So if you go to, I don't know, ask yourself another question. If you did know, what about success is important to you? Someone might say, it's important to me to take care of my family. It's important for me to travel and communicate with other cultures. It's important for me to have God in my life. When you ask yourself the questions, you're just listening for what's valuable. When we define something as important, we're on the trail of our values. The second question I ask is deeper. What about life is important to you? This takes a little more thought. It's a good idea to write out what's important to you in life. Then circle the words and phrases that reveal a value to you. You'll eventually come up with what I call your driving values. A driving value is a little different from general values. The driving value is what most motivates your life. And so, if you're not living your driving values, you're going to create pain for yourself. Let's take the example of someone identifying abundance and wealth as being a driving value. If wealth is indeed important to that person, if he chooses a job where the wealth-building capacity is very limited, that's going to create anxiety if wealth is a driving value in that person's psyche. For other people, wealth may not be a driving value. As long as they're getting a paycheck and they're taking care of their needs and their family needs, that's enough for them. Their driving value might be creativity or the arts. So they might pursue an artistic career, even though it's often challenging to make a lot of money in the arts. Or their driving value might be social activism or counseling. So they pursue the path of working for nonprofit agencies. The most important thing is for you to identify what your own driving values are. Another reason to know your values is to help you understand when you're in a values conflict in your relationships. For example, if you really want to have children and you're in a relationship with someone that doesn't want to have children, you've got a major value conflict, particularly if having the child is the driving value in your life. If the two of you end up compromising your values, this doesn't usually work, and sooner or later, you'll both be consumed by resentment and frustration. It may mean, instead, that you both have to make choices aligned with your respective highest values, even if this requires that you decide not to be a couple. If you're not living your values, you will feel stress and discomfort. And that stress and discomfort are good, because they're the signal that you're alienated from your own values. If you are denying your highest values, your driving values, you're denying yourself. And if you deny yourself long enough, pretty soon you'll have to map that over with the lies you tell yourself until you no longer know what is true for you. Sometimes you'll just go numb and live your life, as Thoreau put it, in quiet desperation. Sometimes you'll feel exhausted and irritable. Sometimes you'll feel that life has lost any sense of fun. Sometimes you just don't know why you're here. All these are symptoms of lying to yourself about your true values. If you're in that situation, it's a particularly fortunate moment when you stop in your tracks and say, "How did I get myself into this low place of energy and discontent?" You got yourself there by not living your driving values. The questions in this section will help you get unstuck. Values are connected to integrity. One huge aspect of integrity is your ability to keep your commitments to yourself. Another equally huge part is being aligned in your thoughts and your actions. Your ability to be in alignment between thought and action depends on first understanding what your highest values are. Integrity has a lot to do with telling yourself the truth. Tell yourself the truth about your fears, about your strengths, your abilities, your gifts, your shortcomings, what is working in your life, and what is not working. When you do an honest self-evaluation of exactly where you are right now, you're opening yourself up to more integrity coming into your life. Another thing to consider in pondering values is to know the difference between values and judgments. Very often, we respond to others who hold different values from our own by judging them. While it's true that you want to be in closest relationship with people who share your values and make choices in that direction, it's also true that being part of a very diverse society, indeed a global community, will bring you into contact with people whose values you don't share. Sometimes when we come up against a values conflict, we end up telling ourselves a story about it. We label it and then tell a story. "You should see it this way," or, "I don't think this is very responsible. Now, if I were doing X, I do it this way, and so forth. Being able to separate values from judgment is a mark of spiritual maturity. It's a realization that despite holding different values, we are all valuable as human beings. Values are about you understanding who you are. It's not about dividing you from everybody else. Let's face it, if everyone held exactly the same values in exactly the same way, life would be very boring. That doesn't mean that you never speak out against injustice, nor does it mean that you have to accept another's value as being acceptable to you. Again, real spiritual maturity is the ability to speak our own truth and perspective, even if this opposes another, without slipping into judgment of that person as a human being. Use the questions in this section to help you uncover your own driving values. A really interesting exercise might be to have a friend, colleague, or family member answer the same questions.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.